Nasser Omer is an accountant, husband, and father of two grown kids. This Indian American is also a devout Muslim, and as such, he tries to get to his nearest mosque as often as possible to pray.
For Muslim men, it is mandatory to pray 5 times a day in congregation. That is the reason we need to go to the mosque.
Omer lives in Kennesaw, Georgia, a rural community of about 30,000 people. It's just over 25 miles northwest of Atlanta, a quiet town, one where Confederate flags fly freely. There are at least 40 different churches in Kennesaw, but no mosque. So Omer, one of perhaps 100 Muslims in town, has to drive to the neighboring town of Marietta, where there are a couple of mosques.
How far is the nearest mosque for you to go to now?
It's about 10 miles from here, and it takes about 30 minutes from my home to the mosque, one way. After the prayers, again 30 minutes to come back.
A few months ago, Omer and a few other Muslim families decided they'd like to open their own small mosque in their own town. They found this strip mall, which had multiple vacancies, the price was right, and so they filed the paperwork to open a small storefront mosque right here. It's similar to what this Pentecostal church had done a few months before in a different strip mall. To help them with the process, they enlisted a local Muslim community leader, Amjad Tawfiq. He'd helped set up another mosque in Marietta.
So why does Kennesaw need a mosque?
Well, I mean, Muslims try to make it 5 times a day to the mosque, and in this day and age, it's a little difficult to be there 5 times a day. But usually, if you are close enough, 5-10 minutes drive, you can go there early in the morning prayers, in the evening prayers at least, and you build up the community.
At first, the application process was routine. The zoning board okayed the idea, but as word got out about the proposed mosque, some opponents showed up in force at the next planning commission meeting. Chris Eaton Welsh, who thinks the mosque should be approved, sits on the Kennesaw City Council.
From my understanding, there were over 200 people that showed up to the meeting.
And that's unusual?
Very unusual. You might have 3 people, 5 people.
Is that right? Normally 3 people show up? We got 200 this time.
200 people show up this time. And it was, you can't let this in our community. They're going to practice Sharia law. And lots of fear. And I believe misunderstanding in the community.
It certainly didn't help that the day before the city council was to hold their next meeting to discuss the mosque, the Islamic militant group ISIS released another video showing the beheading of another American, this time aid worker and former U.S. Army Ranger Peter Kasig. Welsh says this ongoing violence by some Muslims in the Middle East made any moves by a Muslim group in Georgia seem suspicious to some people in her community.
And they're seeing it every single night on the news. And I think that instills...
Seeing ISIS and Al-Qaeda beheadings. And so they thought that this was going to be an outpost for ISIS.
Yes, absolutely.
Over the last couple of days, we've been asking people around town what they think about the proposed mosque. And the reactions have been split about 50-50. Half the people for, half against. The interesting thing, though, is that the people who are against the mosque were very reluctant to talk with us about it on camera. Supporters of the mosque, however, were very eager to talk.
You know, they have every right to worship where they want. It really doesn't bother me. I mean, I hope it goes through for them, and, you know, I hope it's successful.
I don't have a problem with the mosque coming to town. I think that this country is built on religious freedom, and I think that we should respect that.
I do have prejudices like everybody else has been formed with all the 911 and everything that's been going on. I'm a live and let live type of person, and as long as people are good citizens, I try to be, it's okay with me.
I don't want Sharia law in Georgia.
We were able to track down one critic who would speak publicly. Chad Legere works at a fireproofing company and lives in a neighboring Georgia town. He says from what he's seen of groups like ISIS and Al-Qaeda, he can't trust the intentions of any Muslims.
Do you know the people who are behind this mosque? I mean, they say, we've been living in this community for decades, some of them 20, 30 years. We've raised our families, we go to school, and we have never shown a trace of violence. Mm-hmm. Does that example not convince you that they might have different intentions than you think?
Like I said, prove it. Go on record condemning ISIS. I haven't seen it, and definitely not on a widespread level. Why are Christians running around scared? Why do they need to put a mosque inside a shopping center? What's the next step? Walmarts? We're going to have a mosque at every Walmart?
What they've seen in the news media, a small, you know, group of people acting upon themselves, calling themselves Muslims and doing the things that are heinous crimes. And we as a Muslims in America, you know, definitely do not condone those acts at all. We condemn those acts. We are against those as much as anybody else.
You know, you mentioned this, that you condemn these acts. And this is one of the things that we heard from people, is that they feel that the American Muslim community doesn't do enough to condemn the acts of ISIS and Al-Qaeda. What is your response to that?
I'm really, you know, trying to do this for past so many years. It's just, don't know how else can we go out and reach out to the community to tell them that we have done that and continue to do that. There are websites which gives links after links after links where Muslims, not only in the United States of America, but all around the world, have condemned these acts. And we continue to do that because this is really not Islam.
I'm a practicing Catholic. You know, I don't understand the religion, but I know that our founding fathers meant it when they penned the Constitution. And that means that whether I agree with it or not, they've got the right to be there.
But City Council Member Welsh says the anti-Muslim vitriol only got worse when the City Council had to finally vote to approve or deny the proposed mosque. Welsh, who by day is a chiropractor, wife, and mom of two young girls, says the day of that vote was a scary one.
The Monday of the vote, around 4 o'clock in the afternoon, I was here in my office, and a police officer came over in the middle of my patient hours and said that she needed to speak to me. And I was like, I'm really busy. And she said, no, I have to talk to you now. And my Facebook information, my children's pictures, my office phone number, my home address, my office Facebook page had all been released onto a hate site. And sending me some very graphic torture pictures of ISIS and saying, this is the kind of thing that you're trying to bring to our community. What kind of person are you? And at that point, I got a little rattled.
Anti-Islamic protesters demonstrated outside Kennesaw City Hall.
The police escorted Welsh over to City Hall for the vote. Protesters had already been gathering, many from out of town, and they were happy to speak out.
To me, it's a threat to my freedom, my liberties, and everything I own, including my kids' lives and my life for that matter.
They're training their kids how to do terrible things to Americans, and we're trying to stop it.
That night, the city council voted down the proposed mosque 4-1. Welsh was the only one voting in favor.
The city council didn't give any reason why they rejected the mosque proposal, and no one on the council, apart from Welsh, would talk with us. The mayor of Kennesaw has said that the debate had nothing to do with religion. Instead, he said it was based on concerns about proper zoning, parking, and traffic congestion.
But Atlanta attorney Doug Dillard says those can't be the sole reasons.
Parking, traffic, hours of operation, all that kind of thing can be dealt with, but they cannot be in and of themselves a reason to deny the application.
Dillard is building a lawsuit against Kennesaw on behalf of the mosque group. He represented two other mosques in two other Georgia towns in recent years who'd been denied permits to build or expand, and both times he'd helped the mosques move forward. Dillard says Kennesaw, just like those other towns, is violating both constitutional and federal protections against religious discrimination. Dillard says, just look at that Pentecostal church that was allowed in that other strip mall. He says Kennesaw can't greenlight a Christian church and then turn around and deny the Muslim mosque.
And I think the reason for the opposition is that this is a group of Muslims. They don't want them to worship in Kennesaw, period. I don't care where you put them.
But do you have any evidence that that's the case?
Only through their actions of proven Christian and opposing the Muslims. And if you look at the opposition, terrorists go home. It's pretty evident that the opposition is uninformed and is putting forth an argument that's not lawful.
On top of Dillard's proposed lawsuit, the U.S. Justice Department told the NewsHour it was also looking into the situation in Kennesaw.
Given the immense blowback and that the mosque was voted down, do you wish you had not stepped out and publicly declared yourself in favor?
I don't like the publicity. I don't like the spotlight. I don't like any of that. I still think it was the right thing to do for me. And I would still do it again.
Facing a possible lawsuit and a possible federal investigation, the Kennesaw City Council last week made a dramatic turnaround. The four members of the council who'd voted no asked that their votes be withdrawn and changed to yes votes. That made for unanimous approval of the mosque's permit. If nothing changes, supporters of the mosque say they'll drop their lawsuit and hopefully soon begin work preparing the site.